Last night on The Bachelor Australia, history was made. Now obviously, spoiler alert, alright, stop watching if you don't want to know that Dumbledore dies. And also the results of The Bachelor and shit. But yeah, Dumbledore dies. I'm sorry if you're just hearing this now.
Avada Kedavra.
Snape just gives him the don't argue, just Avada Kedavra's his soul right in front of Harry. Which is exactly how Brit would have felt when Nick Avada Kedavra'd her soul in front of a million people on The Bachelor last night.
Right now, I can't give 100% of me to you.
Avada Kedavra.
The episode started off just like any other Bachelor finale. Way too many drone shots, a shit ton of product placement, and Osher was looking fly as fuck. Dressed to the nines, not a hair out of place. Like seriously, what is your secret, man? But for the first time in Bachelor history, at the end, the Bachelor chose no one. I didn't know you could fucking do that.
I am not able to wholeheartedly commit to you.
You didn't pick me either. You pick nobody.
Are you kidding me?
Turns out Nick Cummins ain't gonna be coming anytime soon. There were two girls in the final, Sophie and Brittany. And after 2 months of getting to know them, he just went, yeah, nah, not feeling it, girls. Catch you on the flip. And just left.
He picked no one. Is that about right? He literally picked no one.
At this point, I was confused because at first I was like, oh, it's a draw. Surely that just means 5 minutes of time on, or a penalty shootout between Sophie and Britt. I was so keen. And then it dawned on me that he's just gonna have a wank and go home. Man, the honey badge has changed the game. He's thrown out the rule book and gone rogue. It's like in Air Bud when they let the dog play basketball.
But you won't find anything in there that says a dog can't play.
He's right! Ain't no rule said the dog can't play basketball.
There also ain't no rule in the book that says you have to choose someone at the end. Checkmate.
Right now, I'm a little bit lost.
How? Even I know where you are. You're at the Sheridan Hotel in New Caledonia. Get a map, man. It's 2018. There's one in your phone.
I hate hurting people, and I've done that twice today.
And over 20 other times throughout the season as well. So the Honey Badger has legit just taken Channel 10 for a ride. We're talking 8 weeks of free accommodation in a mansion, countless free rides in sports cars, boats, jet skis, and helicopters, not to mention skydiving. He got a free boys trip to New Caledonia with Osher and unlimited beers. Game, set, match. People are saying, oh, nobody won The Bachelor this year. Are we watching the same show? Nick won. He just clocked The Bachelor. Everyone's been playing checkers. The Honey Badger's been playing chess this whole goddamn time. Outplayed us all. Fucking hats off to you, Nick. Also, let's be honest, in hindsight, we should have all seen this coming. He was treating The Bachelor like a blue light disco, just macking anything with a pulse. As Nick would say, his tongue was busier than a one-armed bricklayer in Baghdad, buddy. In there like a rat up a drain pipe, some shit. A lot of people aren't happy with the result, but if you thought you were pissed off, imagine being the head of Sportsbet. They had to refund all bets relating to The Bachelor. According to his Instagram bio, the Honey Badger is an ex-rugby player, traveller and adventurer. And now we can add professional time waster to that list too, because this shit went for 2 months.
What a giant waste of time that was.
Like, I'm all for wasting people's time, trust me. Like, ask my high school teachers. But there's a line. Like, I didn't string them along for 8 weeks, meet their families, and take them overseas just to be like, yeah, look, I'm just not that into quadratic equations. I'll be honest, there was a brief moment there where I actually thought my dream was coming true. That a bachelor finally realized that the real winner had been standing in front of them the whole time.
Sharp as always, mate.
And egg.
But they never learn. I'm honestly surprised that this hasn't happened sooner. Like, I checked, and I'm pretty sure this is a world first. It's never happened before that there's been no winner. But it's not that ridiculous. If you're given the option of 20 random people, there's a fair chance that the person you want to spend the rest of your life with isn't one of them. Statistically, it's ridiculous that The Bachelor ever chooses someone. Also, props to Brooke. She bowed a week earlier. You could really say she got out of there in the nick of time, because his name's Nick. Yep. Yeah. All right. At the end of the day, yes, it sucks that he was wasting the girl's time, but also, good on Nick for being honest and not just choosing someone for the sake of it and then ending it a week later like old mate Blake. Look, it's hard to comment on what actually happened because he was probably forced to string them along for the purposes of TV, or maybe he did realize at the end that he wasn't ready for a relationship. But either way, it's a reality TV show, so it doesn't matter.
I came here for a chance at love. I'm gonna have to start again. She's out there.
I love the way they try and foreshadow a sequel, like season 2, The Honey Badger Strikes Back. Unless halfway through, Osha turns to Nick and says, "I'm your father," I'm not interested.
I am your father.
Yeah, I didn't really know how to end this video, so I'm probably gonna do a Brooke and just walk out. So thanks for watching. And you are fool's gold. Yeah.